If there are accidents on the International Space Station, the crew has to be able to escape at a moment's notice. This will be their life raft. It's codenamed X-38, and it's being designed for a one-way emergency trip home.
And if we ever need it, if someone gets hurt on a station, or becomes ill, if there's a problem with the station, or there's a problem with the shuttle where we can't get the shuttle up fast enough to do something that we need with the crew, then they'll get in, power it up, and come on home.
This type of space plane is known as a lifting body. The technology is nothing new. The Russians were testing it back in the 1950s. These craft do not have wings. The body provides lift, and a parachute brings it back down to Earth. Edwards Air Force Base, March 1999. The X-38 is being put through its final tests. NASA has to make sure this life raft could fly down through the atmosphere and make it back to Earth. It will be permanently docked on the International Space Station, ready for an emergency. In this drop test, the X-38 is carried to an altitude of 45,000 feet under the wing of a B-52 bomber. From the B-52, it's a 10-minute flight. From the space station, 250 miles up, it will take 2 hours to reach the ground. Feet above the ground, a giant parafoil is released.
The wing area of this parafoil, this big square parachute, is as big as the wing area of a Boeing 747. And we release it comes up at 100 foot per second out of the vehicle, and we inflate it and get it up and flying and keep everything stable enough. That's very unique. Nothing like that's ever really been done before.
Quality is into the wind. Flavor's looking good.
And what we found was people didn't understand the physics involved very well. And by actually embedding sensors in the cloth so we could measure what was going on, we've been able to really understand what goes on in these parafoils and make them a very reliable device.
The crash landing would be jarring, but X-38 could save the lives of up to 8 astronauts.
10 minutes to shut down.
But NASA hopes this escape system will never be needed.